Hey guys, what's going on? In previous video we have installed the WordPress on our Windows machine. Now in this video we will be enumerating this WordPress. So let's go to my computer, C, XAMPP, and in htdocs we have the WordPress folder, and you can see these are the files. So I'll be explaining the main important files. The first one is wp-admin. So here, if you have access to this wp-admin, if you have the login credentials, then you can exploit any of this PHP and get the reversal. So, and wp-content, so this is where you will have the plugins. So here there is a default plugin, Akismet, and you can also upload the plugins and you can also download from the WordPress, and there are some themes, 2021, 2020 and 2019. So if you have the access to the dashboard, you can exploit any of the theme. So uploads. So here this content should be very carefully enumerated. So this is empty. Normally if you have some files.php, so if you access it via browser, those files will get automatically executed. So that's why you need to be very careful. So this is the about WP content and WP admin. So WP includes all the other stuff like JavaScript files and CSS files, etc., and other fonts, etc., all other except administrative ones. So this is where you can find some juicy information in WP includes. And license.txt, so in this license you can find the WordPress version. And wp-activate.php, so this could be used for the mail purpose, and blog header, comments, post, etc. And another important thing is wp-config.php. So this we have connected to database, right, when we are setting up the WordPress, so that logon credentials will be saved in this file. So you can see database name is WordPress and the username is root and password is root. So that means after getting the reversal, you can read this file wp-config.php and you can see the connection to the database. So it's similar to a PHP configuration file. So if you have access this, you can log on to the SQL database and you can see much more information if you have more than this table. So this is one of the very important files. So wp-config sample is a sample file. It will come pre-default with the WordPress. So by default you will not get wp-config.php, you will get only this one. So when we created the database, this file gets created, and wp-cron, wp-load.php. So some certain plugins will use this wp-load.php. So you can also use exploit this wp-load.php, and wp-login, wp-mail settings, etc. And last one is xml-rpc. So I will be explaining in detail about in the next videos, but anyway I will explain briefly in this video. So XML-RPC, RPC stands for remote procedure call. So there are some functions on our machine, okay, pinging and getting the user info, getting the post info, getting the comment info. So there are some applications that uses XML-RPC. So they will construct a call in via XML format, and that will be sent to this XML-RPC, and this will execute that function. So we'll be looking about this XML-RPC, how to exploit this one using the Burp Suite and Python. So for now there are some functions in our this WordPress, and those functions can be called using this XML-RPC. Okay, now this is the content. If you go to the WordPress website, you can see here the url/uri, that is the WordPress. Normally if you go to the root directory, you will get the WordPress websites, but we have installed in the WordPress folder. Okay, and now we can enumerate this. So to do WordPress enumeration, you need the WordPress wordlist. Google for WordPress wordlist and you will get see this one, secrets-wordpress.fuzz, and you can download this one, and I have already downloaded this one. You can see wordpress.fuzz.txt. now you can use the GoBuster So you need to put the WordPress here. Let me check the IP address, and it's 102, and you can also check for WP content and uploads. So here you can see if you upload anything, it should be processed here. So currently it's empty, so you don't need to expose that uploads folder. Put the threads as 20 and the word list as home carry. And WordPress dot wordlist. I think we are good to go. And let me stop this one, and I can say quite, so we'll get only URLs. So you can see almost everything has been by default, so we did not put any security permissions. So you can see all the status codes as 200 and some redirects. So you can see this is the admin panel. So you can see almost everything is accessible. So that's how you enumerate the WordPress using the WordPress wordlist. We can also manually check for xmlrpc.php. So XMLRPC server accepts post requests only. So we will be exploiting this XMLRPC.php in the upcoming videos.